Welcome to tonight's webinar. I'm going to be your host, Liam Fay, for the Digital Solutions Program. This workshop's been brought to you by Digital Solutions Business Station through the Commonwealth Government of Australia's program. A little bit about me to begin with. I'm a serial entrepreneur, have several businesses, creative director, have one of the largest marketing production companies in Queensland, focusing on social media. Been in business now for 14 years, creating content for all sorts of businesses across all different types of industries. And tonight's webinar, Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok, I'm going to be showing you how TikTok works, how to create content, what you need to go viral, what's currently trending, and why you need to be on TikTok now. So let's start with the last one. Why should you be on TikTok? TikTok is one of the fastest growing platforms in Australia. At the moment, one third of Australians over the age of 18 are now on TikTok. So you can reach a huge audience of people. The demographic is definitely young, but it is heading northward. I had a consultation with a client recently who was in their 60s who actively uses TikTok every single day. The platform is very addictive. The great thing about this platform is it's the one platform out there where you can put up a video today, have it go viral and have over a million likes on it, views on it, by the end of the week. With every other social media platform, it's really driven by engagement. With TikTok, you post the video, it goes out to a small audience. If that small audience engages with it, goes out to a slightly bigger audience. If they engage with it, goes to a bigger one. So I'm going to jump straight in and show you how to use it today. For those of you that are watching this later online, feel free to reach out to me. For those watching it live at the moment, you can use the chat functions below if you have any questions as I go. I do try and answer them occasionally. So this is a totally live workshop in that I'm not sure what content's going to come up. It's going to be fairly random. So potential content warning. Let me get my screen shared. Okay, so jump straight into TikTok. When you immediately load TikTok, and keep in mind TikTok is best used on your mobile phone, but when you first jump into it, straight away, it will load a video and start playing with audio. For this case, it looks like I've got old, what looks like Tom and Jerry type video with a stitch at the end. So I'm gonna stop that from replaying over and over. But at the top here, has some of our functionality. So we have the For You section. This is a random selection of videos. We have the following. So those are the pages and accounts that you're interested in, that you're following, much like on Facebook and Instagram. You have Live. That's just all the live videos at the moment. It's got a few suggested accounts. We've got the option to upload from desktop. Again, recommend you use the mobile version. It has a lot more functionality. Messages, where you can talk with your friends and people message you backwards and forwards. You can only get messages if you both follow each other. Inbox, that's all your notifications, and then your profile icon. So much the same as every other social media, you have your platform, you have your likes, comments, and shares. And the content that's going to show you is what TikTok thinks you're going to be interested in. The content that I get on my mobile phone is definitely very different to the content that I get on my desktop version. For whatever reason, I'm not entirely sure, it's part of the algorithm. What I am sure about is the sort of content that people are going to engage with. So let's jump over and have a look. I don't want that one just yet. This is one of my favorite videos. This is a local Australian creator. He's a mechanic, Pokey. He's down in Tasmania and his entire marketing is based entirely on TikTok. And customers asked him a question and he's replied to it. The question being, how many regular customers can you provide services for? Just asking because if your 100K followers all wanted a service, you would be really busy. No doubt about that. So let's listen to Pokey's answer for that one.
All right, so I work on basically, I would estimate maybe, and I don't reckon it's even this high, would be 1% would be in my area followers on TikTok. It may be a little bit higher, it might be lower. That's 1,450 people. If I get half of them as customers, I'm doing amazingly well and this makes this worthwhile. A lot of my customers tell me they come from seeing us on TikTok and yeah, it's working. Saying that, would I be able to serve as 100,000 followers? No shop in Australia can handle that. So no, I wouldn't be doing that. But most of the customers, most of the people following me aren't from this area locally, but a small percentage of them are. But that small percentage, even if it's only 1%, is more than I can handle. So yeah, that's how my marketing works.
So really, really good example video to showcase how it works. He's got a lot more followers since then. Really interesting thing to note is that the style and approach is just him holding his phone, walking around. Your TikTok videos don't need to be elaborate productions. If you do them and they're very real, your customers tend to connect with them, the more real you can make them. And all his videos are very much the same style. So if we dig into a few more of his videos, as you can see, most of them face the camera type style.
So this question's come up a few times on the ad for us to get a mechanic at Pokies Mechanical. And it's a very relative question.
Again, face the camera.
Asking you shall receive, sir. Off, clutches off.
When he is explaining things, he points the camera towards what he's talking about.
Is off,
so it leads to a very good result. Customers are able to connect with. One of the big things that you have to understand is, regardless of what industry you're in, most customers only ever see as far as the front counter. So if you take your customers behind the scenes and show them a little bit more of what's going on, it's going to be interesting to them. It's behind the scenes, it's every day for you, but for customers, it's interesting. And essentially, that's how he's built his audience. He's just showing the things that he's doing. And it really doesn't matter what industry you're in, for the most part, it's unique and interesting for everyone. So you can see at the moment, he has 175,000 followers on TikTok. Okay, so I want to point out to you that TikTok definitely started out as a music platform. It was very largely focused in that space. I call this one "Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok," because I definitely don't like to dance, but it definitely did have a music focus. So I want to show you this video. It's from a Canadian creator, and he plays multiple different versions of himself in a way that's very interesting. So, and as you can see, it does get a lot of attention. So let's watch this one.
Yo, 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 what is he doing? Oh yeah, so he was telling me that if you cut a carrot a certain way, you can play it like a flute. He really thinks that's gonna work? Apparently it's a thing. Just ignore him. Ready? Yeah, do me a favor, pull up that... pull up that one session with...
Yeah, look, they said that I couldn't do it, so I went and did it. W's only, you know I've been winning. Top of the world, the globe is.
So he's gone down that pathway. That's his style video. He does do some more sort of generic ones, but as far as production goes, everything's shot off a mobile phone with audio overlaid over the top. It works very effectively, it attracts a lot of attention and draws people into his music. So let's have a look at another one. This one is one of my favorite ones. I show it most of the time when I do these webinars, because it hits on the fact of being very, very real. Before I play this video, I do want to point out that with TikTok, you do have your captions and you have your hashtags. So you want to be using hashtags that are kind of connected and relate to your audience. Underneath that, you also have options to add music. If a customer listens to that sound, they're more likely to see more videos based on that sound. So it's a good idea to see what songs are trending on TikTok and then overlay those in your video. To get those songs onto your video, you do it while you're editing. There'll be an option there to add sound. Then you pick out the music you want.
behind to start the next big restaurant brand. We started off small with this plot of land and built everything we could by ourselves. We got this trailer to start and get proof of concept out to the people as fast as we could. We built everything and made it look really awesome and nice. But then we had to close. Shortly after, we managed to lease out this restaurant space and we built it up by hand ourselves. Piece by piece, wall by wall, hour by hour, day by day, we built it up and we finally got open. And this is where our story begins. This is us.
So, a very simple mix of little clips and videos put together, and he's put his own voiceover over the top. When you're editing your video together in the TikTok app, and I definitely do recommend you edit in the app, you've got the option there to remove the sound, and then you can put your own voice over the top. So you can film all your videos and then just put your audio over the top. So for reference, that video, that was his very first one that went up, and around the time it went up, it got about 1 million views. It's had another 600,000 since then. I suppose people are interested to see what the first video is. But it performed quite well and pushed their brand up there so more people could see it. Most of his videos sort of get around that 50,000 mark, 250,000 mark. The interesting thing with TikTok is you could have a video with 1 million views, the next one will have 10,000 views. It's purely based on how interested people are in the content. So every single video you put out there, you really want to create something interesting that people are going to see, tell a story. Storytelling is one of the biggest factors when creating videos. Now, some of his other videos, 2.6 million views, those sort of things. So just because you have a good video doesn't mean all your videos are going to be good. Because when you put content on TikTok, it goes out to a small audience. If that audience engages with it, goes to a bigger one. If they engage with it, goes to a bigger one, and so forth. His videos, again, much like Pokey's approach, is just sort of,
as the cheese boss, I think,
post the camera type things. In this case, he's using a green screen effect, but showcasing what they're doing. I don't think that's his, but showcasing what they're doing and telling a little bit of story about the product. So your videos that you actually put on TikTok do not need to be over the top. You just got to make sure that you're very clear when you're telling your message. For those of you that are joining late, if you have a question, you can use the chat or question and answer functions at the bottom of your Zoom controls. So if you got one, let me know. So the next thing I want to point out is that TikTok is really, really great for niche markets. If you have a very small market in the mainstream, it's actually very easy to access your market on TikTok. So for instance, ADHD on TikTok is something that's very publicized. There's whole communities around it. There's a lot of people that think they have ADHD and a lot of people that do. So you can actually access a market that's a little bit of a niche audience. So let's watch this video.
That's what I forgot, my keys. Hold on. Oh my God, I forgot my keys too. And I forgot to breathe. This is so boring, I can't stay focused. I'm actually really interested in this topic, but I can't focus because the pattern on the wall looks like a puppy. Hold on, I gotta pee. Dude, I've had to pee for like the last 3 hours. Come on, man. Why'd I walk in this room? Oh, because why'd I walk in this room? What was I doing? Crap, now I'm stuck. That's what I forgot, my keys. Hold on, oh my God, I forgot my keys too.
So it creates a little bit of a looping video, but it's very engaging for people to go, hey, I recognize that, I suffer from that. So you can actually access a very niche audience on here. With all things TikTok, it wouldn't be social media if there wasn't some sort of pets and animals on there. Always be prankful.
January, February, March, April.
This was actually a trend that came out as well towards the start of the year, where it's like, how much did you make in your industry for each month if they're like self-employed and those sort of things, or in this case, a cat influencer. As you can see, quite a lot of information in the captions and also hashtags. So if I follow these hashtags, I'll find more videos like this. If I follow the audio line, I'm going to find more videos where they talk about what they made and incomes and those sort of things. So I can follow that sound to track the same sort of videos. Okay, So something that I see all the time, and again, playing into that niche market, is I fly planes. It's something I enjoy doing. So I definitely get the videos with the aircraft. So I want to point this one out. The interesting thing about this video is the audio they chose. It's got the song from Wednesday, Adams. If anyone who's following the Wednesday show on TikTok, you've probably heard that one before, but they use that audio. So when I click on that audio, I'm finding anything that's used that same sound. The main audio, though, is one of the trends that's going viral on TikTok. And I know it's Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok workshop. This is that viral trend going around at the moment, where you do the Wednesday dance, again, playing with that audio sound. So the audio and songs and music you choose is very important, because again, anyone who's listened to that sound is more likely to see videos with that sound in it in upcoming videos that they watch. Okay, so at this point in time, I want to jump into a real world example. So this is a business I worked with, Millennium Comics and Collectibles in Rockhampton. When I first met the owner of this business, they were closing down. Over the course of about 4 years, we took them from closing down to being the largest pop culture store in the Southern Hemisphere. Possibly third or fourth largest in the world, somewhere around that sort of size. Haven't been to all of them. TikTok's in the early days when we were starting to develop them and push them forward, actually did play a part. We haven't focused so much on TikTok recently, as we've had two different launches with them, one for the store and one for the cafe they opened. But within the space of what we did in the old store, we ran a couple of TikTok videos. And what we found was the previous year, they had around about 160,000 people go through to their website throughout the entire year. Once we started posting on TikTok and we had a couple of videos go viral in that 100K mark, we had about 100,000 people go to the website in the space of 1 month. This naturally translated through to sales. We had people as far away as Germany commenting on these videos. So we tried a few different styles to begin with, different things that we thought might work, and then we found something that did work. Let's watch it.
Series based on comics. Lock and Key. The Witcher. Netflix.
So a very, very simple approach to video, just showing the different comics out there. This one attracted a huge amount of attention. It's got a little bit of controversy there because people commenting around The Witcher game came out first, but fix that up. Books first, then games, then comics, then TV series. So it did work. But this video went viral, 900,000 views on. So we backed it up, did a part two. We got 4,000 views on it, backed it up again, and got 12,000 views. And from there, we sort of just been trickling a bit of TikTok occasionally.
Netflix series based on...
Again, following that same sort of approach. So when you discover something that does work and your audience connects with it, I recommend repeating that style, repeating that strategy over and over again until it stops working. TikTok's definitely one of those platforms where you want to be focusing on mass production of content. You want to be doing different styles, different approaches, trying different things until you get that one video that takes off. Once you get a video that takes off, draws that engagement, engagement being liking, tagging, sharing, commenting, clicking, replaying, downloading your video, stitching with it, then you are more likely with that approach to get more people viewing that sort of content. People keep coming back for it because they're used to that style. If you use the same audio, they're more likely to see more videos in that space. It's As a creator, it's hard for me to say this, but you can essentially do anything these days with your mobile phones. You don't need a production company to come in and create content for TikTok. So the next thing that I want to show you is actually my personal TikTok account. I put up a mix of different content from me playing around with my planes, travel, skits and stupid things, and including a few videos that went viral. So 250,000 views on one of the stupidest videos possible. I'm going to show you that, but we'll take you through a little bit first.
I work a job. I get paid for that job, and then I use that money to buy childish things like this.
Nice and simple sort of videos. This is sort of the thing that I normally post. This is my personal account. I just like to play on it. Some of my staff, teams, travel, my cat. But then I had a mate go, it's very hard to go viral on TikTok. You know, nothing you can do is going to be easy. Really going to work it. And I went, hold my beer. I'm going to show you how easy it is. And I put up this video.
What is the weight difference between regular and large fries?
Now with this as well, I used a computer generated voiceover. That's one of the options when you're editing.
117 grams for regular.
You don't need any flash editing software. You just need your phone, and you also need the TikTok. You can do all the editing to create anything you want on TikTok.
Like 20 more grams.
130 to grams for large. What the 15 grams difference looks like in said looking fries.
So this video went absolutely viral, 250,000 views on it, thousands of likes, 100 odd comments. And it went viral because I added the opportunity there for the controversy. I didn't show all the detail in the video, I didn't show how I did everything. And the audience picked that up. Everyone asked some questions and drove into it. Occasionally, I've got a couple of people who just like the idea of trolling, and trolls are your friend in this sort of thing.
What is the
same sort of video, because someone's like, oh, it's, anyone can go viral with that type of video. I did the same thing again with KFC, followed the same sort of approach, but I showed everything. In this video, it didn't get the same sort of attention, didn't get the same sort of results. There was nothing that people could really tag on or comment on about it. All the information is in the video.
Eight difference between KFC large and regular chips. ...111 grams for regular. ...248 grams for large. This is what the 137 grams difference looks like.
So very, very simple approach to actually creating the video. And didn't get that as much attention. There was nothing that people could click on, nothing that people could comment on or draw attention to because I gave all the detail. So ideally when you're creating your videos, you want to show enough, but don't go too overboard because you want the opportunity for people to get show interest and actually ask questions. Questions are really, really effective and really good for your engagement algorithm. You want as many of those as you can actually get in there. Now, I keep coming back, the TikTok app for your mobile phone is the best way to do it. And your mobile phone is essentially all you need. When you're creating content for social media, it doesn't matter if it's TikTok or Facebook or YouTube or Instagram, any of them, this device is wonderful. There's a few things you can do though to make this better. So the first thing is you have to realize where your microphone is on your phone. And you also want to make sure that you're shooting in vertical. Vertical is much better for mobile display, and it's the only way you want to be shooting if you're shooting TikTok. So if you don't know where your microphone is, and if you've got a later version smartphone, like I do, when you switch between your external camera, the one facing out, the outputs camera, and your internal camera, you might find that your microphone is actually in two different places. So the easiest way to find this is to set your camera filming, move your finger around the outside, and keep talking as you're doing it, say that your finger's at the top, coming around the side. When your phone starts to get real muted with your audio, that's where your microphone is. So in my particular case, when I'm using the front-facing camera, my microphone's at the top. When I'm using the internal camera, my microphone is at the bottom. So you want to make sure that your fingers are not holding or blocking the microphone. And you also want to make sure that your fingers are not in front of the camera. Those are the first two sort of rules of shooting with your phone. Going on from that, the most important thing with any video that you're shooting, and it doesn't matter if it's for TikTok or if it's for cinema, is the story always comes first. If you have a good story, you have a good message that you're trying to bring across, then nothing else really matters. Story always comes first. After that, then we start to go into audio. Audio is the next most important thing. The interesting thing with audio, and I was up in Cairns around about a month or so back filming a TV show up there with one of my staff. He's worked on everything from Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, Married at First Sight, Bachelor, Survivor, Tahiti, all the big productions, TV shows, you name one, he's actually worked on it. We're up there filming a TV show, and he made the comment around audio is that audio technology has not changed in 70 years. What he means by that is the closer you can put the microphone to your subject, the better the audio experience is. Microphones are very simple, they're very, very basic. You want to get the audio as close to your subject as possible to get the best result. So for doing that from your mobile phone, you have a couple of different options. You can put an external microphone onto your phone. The most basic type of microphone is what we call a shotgun mic. Straightforward, it looks like it's long and pointy. When you're using it, the audio pattern spreads out. The closer you are to the microphone, the clearer and the better the audio. The further away you go, the more it spreads out. At the moment, the microphone type that I'm using is a shotgun mic. So if I move closer to my microphone, my audio should be more defined. If I move further away from it, it's going to be more dull. It's going to pick up more audio noise from around the room. These sort of shotgun mics, the most basic ones for your mobile phone, start out at a few dollars and a few different pricing. If you go one for your standard top camera, you do need to buy an adapter. Go into your audio shop, but the type of adapter is a TRS to TRRS cable. looks like this, or like this. It adapts the audio from a standard 3.5 input to the input that your mobile phone can read. So really quite simple. If you're using a later generation smartphone, you also need to adapt it to either USB-C or your Lightning port. Moving up from shotgun microphones, we have your lapel type microphone. These microphones are what we call omnidirectional microphone. They'll collect the audio from a circular range around the microphone. These microphones are designed to get as close to your subject as possible. It's the type that you clip on to your shirt. So you can get a wireless one, or you can run a very long cable to your mobile phone. There's a few different ones. Again, the price varies. You can pick them up reasonably cheap. iPhone as a search term. There you go, wireless ones, $30 from Amazon. Alternatively, go support your local tech shop. I'm sure they'll be able to find something for you. So really, really good quality microphones. The closer you get them to your subject, the better the audio quality is going to be. If these sort of options are outside your budget, technological abilities, what you can do is the headphones that came with your mobile phone, they have a really good microphone on them. Rather than have your earphones in, what you can do is you can just run your cable into your shirt so that your microphone bit's sticking out, and they'll give you kind of the same sort of experience as a lapel mic. So microphone technology, really simple, get it as close as possible. The only other thing you have to worry about is wind noise. So to get rid of that wind noise, that sort of popping and puffing that you'll get in videos, especially if you're filming outside, we use dead cats or wind socks. in the production industry, official name is actually a dead cat. Windsock, wind muff, those sort of things, wind covers, but generally just a dead cat. This is a theory sock that goes over the top of your microphone. And they'll take out all your wind noise. You can get these for your shotgun mics, and you can also get them for your lapel mics. These are your wind socks for your lapels. They just go on the end of your microphone. So after we get our audio quality exactly where we want it, the only other thing that really factors in is your actual video quality. So to get your video quality good, the best way to improve it is to add more light. So a ring light is a really good way to add more lighting simplistically to your scene. So you can get ring lights that actually connect to your mobile phone, and you can get ring lights that are on stands. These sort of lights, you can find them at Kmart and Target, those sort of places, for sort of under the $30 range, under the $50 range, depending on the size that you're looking for. The most important thing with these is that if you are going to use a stand, you've got to make sure that you're not static. As soon as you're static and the camera is static, it becomes very boring. It's just a talking head like I am now. If your subject has some movement and the background's changing, it becomes more interesting. So keep that in mind. If you're going to be using a stand and a fixed camera, then you want to make sure that you're dynamic. You're actually moving in the scene. If you're moving in the scene, then it's going to be more interesting for your audience. If you want to take it up to the next level, you can have the camera moving, yourself moving. You can get some rather quite fantastic gimbals now that will stabilize your footage. You're looking at a few hundred dollars as a starting point for these. If you want to have that dynamic movement, or you're taking people for a tour and don't want to spend a couple hundred dollars, going back to your phone, one of the best ways to do it is to take your phone, lock it in your hands, making sure that you're not blocking your microphone, and lock your elbows down to the side. In this sort of position, when you're walking around, you won't get the up and down movement to the side to side wavy movement in your video. You can create a nice, very, very stable movement if you lock your elbows to the side when you're holding your mobile phone. So there's a few different tips there just to get a better quality image with your phone. If you're having a lot of movement and you want to get flash with your editing, you can shoot at a higher shutter rate, which if you've got a newer model smartphone, it gives you that option, and then slow your footage down. Keep in mind, if you're shooting higher shutter rates, it will affect your audio quality or might not even record audio at all. That's all right if you can add your voiceover later when you're doing your editing. So if the idea of creating videos is just too much for you and it sounds terrible and it's outside your scope, what you can do is you can use the TikTok version of an influencer. Their marketplace is called TikTok Creator Marketplace. So you search for this. What it is a bunch of different creators that are viral, popular on TikTok. And as you can see, they have different sort of styles that can be suitably representative for different brands. And you can explore through these, pick one that you like, and then create a deal with them where they'll create your videos, even promote them to their own socials to promote and showcase your brand. So rather than have your typical TikTok Instagram influencer, they've actually gone through and picked out some of the best creators from around the world to create content for you. So I just got a question here. If you miss a bit, Debbie, don't stress too much because you will get sent a link afterwards. If anyone does have a question for me, now's a really, really great time to ask it as we're heading towards the end of today's webinar. So Creator Marketplace, really good if you don't want to create your own videos. Tentatively, if you can locate a good production house in your region that creates TikTok videos or has experience in doing it, try and work with them. It's always good when you can get content created on the ground in your business. With that as well, if you're purely just research stage and looking for ideas, one of the things that you can do is utilize the search function. So you can look up different types of industries and businesses and find out what they're doing. So if we type in baker, you're going to get different videos with baking. Day in the life of a baker.
It's a day in the life of a baker. My name is Brooke, and this is my bakery, Brookie Bakehouse in Brisbane. Today, the bakery is closed, but that doesn't mean that we're not working on...
So straight off the bat, picked out this video, happens to be an Australian one. You'll tend to find that when you're on TikTok, you'll get around about 50% of your audience and videos that you see and videos that customers see will be Australian, and the rest will be international. So you do tend to get quite a large Aussie audience on here. It is a far-reaching platform. What I mean by that is you're going to reach people that are across Australia as opposed to in your local area. But you only need a small percentage of that audience to be in your local area to be doing very well on here. So what I generally recommend is that you utilize your hashtag functions to try and centralize it to your region. So I'm based in the regional city of Rockhampton in central Queensland. If I type in Rockhampton, Queensland, here's a heap of videos from my area. If I start looking at these hashtags and these sort of things, I'm more than likely to start seeing content from them.
So we're only in Rockhampton for a day, but first we started off our morning at a gluten-free bakery. I got a cheese and bacon.
I actually know where that one is. So this person who looks like they do sort of like a blog tour, that's not nice, they've used the hashtag here, Rockhampton. Actually, quite badly, they haven't done it right, but... I was hoping that was going to be a good so there we go, hashtag Rockhampton. Here's all the videos that have used the hashtag Rockhampton. So you can centralize it to your area by using the right hashtags. In terms of hashtags, much like Instagram, you want to use a couple of them, maybe four, is probably five suitable, good number. You want to use a hashtag that's industry based. So, you know, if you're a baker, hashtag baking. Hashtag baker, then you might use hashtag your city or region that you're in, and then sort of two other hashtags might be you're baking a cake, hashtag wedding cake, just as an example. So you want to use hashtags here that will help connect your audience. I know that car, quite nice. Always fun to look up here. So if you haven't already, the first step with TikTok is to jump on and start seeing what other people are doing. Get an idea for it. The first videos you're going to see in your For You, which is essentially your basic feed, is going to be videos that are going to be really based on what TikTok thinks you're going to be interested in. Keep in mind that same with Facebook, same with Instagram, YouTube, the whole show of social media platforms, it always wants to show you what it thinks you're most interested in, because the more interest you show by liking, tagging, sharing, commenting, engaging, the more scrolling you're going to be doing. The more you scroll down through the feed, the almost endless feed of videos, then the more ads you're going to see. And each time you see an ad, these platforms make money. That's how their systems work. So if we do that now... eventually, if I scroll down for here long enough, I will start to see ads. You can actually buy ads on TikTok. So rather than use the Creator Marketplace, use TikTok's Ads Manager, which works kind of a combination between Facebook ads and Google ads. So you can sort of target out regions and demographics, but you can't target down to individual areas like you can on Facebook. If you're sort of starting out and you haven't done a lot of video production in the past, then what I recommend that you do is you actually start out on Facebook. Start out creating some stories, stories being like nice, short, 15-second type footage. When you get one that you like and approach you like, post that also to your TikTok. You'll find that any of the content that you create for Facebook, on TikTok, you can use across your social media platforms like Instagram Reels, Facebook, and YouTube Shorts. So YouTube Shorts is kind of like stories and reels. They're a little bit later to the party than the other platforms. But you can create very, very similar content across all of them. It makes it easier when you're producing content. In terms of video, video performs best on TikTok and YouTube. It doesn't perform as well in the feed on Facebook and Instagram. It performs well on Instagram and Reels. It performs well on Instagram and Facebook in stories. A lot of people these days are swiping across rather than down on Facebook. They're not looking at the feed, they're only looking at stories. So keep that in mind when you're creating your content. Video in the feed doesn't normally perform well for Facebook and Instagram, but it's really your only option with TikTok. With TikTok, you can have actually a slideshow of photos and put audio and video over the top. So that is an option if you want to shortcut the video creation process just by having a series of photos and telling a story about those photos. That's a fairly new option that's come with TikTok. So if anyone has the question from the audience, now's a really good time to ask it. If you have been watching this online and you have a question later, do feel free to reach out to me at Business Station. While you type your questions, if you do have one, I do want to let you know about the Digital Solutions Program. So if you haven't already, jump onto Business Station and have a look at the Digital Solutions Program. Inside here, for $44, you can receive 3 hours of personalized one-to-one business advice with me or one of the other business advisors. Registering for the program is really quite simple. Get onto our Digital Solutions page on Business Station, click for the register for your program, and inside here, put your basic details down. To access the program, for our program, you have to be in Queensland, Western Australia, Northern Territory, and have less than 20 employees. Be registered with an ABN. So it's a really, really good program to get into if you haven't already signed up for it, because we can do things like go through and create and develop a content strategy for you. So actually knowing what to post. In terms of what I normally like to post and what I suggest is post things that represent your brand, your capability, posts that lead people to create action, and posts that are testimonial based. So just with the action one, once you have 1,000 people liking your business page, then you can add a link through to your website. That really increases your traffic through to your website if you can get that. So those four things, branding. Branding, first of all, is really the who you are and what your values are. People generally think branding and think it's just your logo, but it goes a lot deeper than that. When you're posting things about your branding, you're really asking your customer to form an opinion about your business. If we look at two of the biggest brands out there at the moment, mobile phone technology, Samsung and Apple, I'm a Samsung user every single day of the week, and I always will be, simply because every Apple screen I see is always cracked. So I think Apple, and I think cracked screens, low quality. I'm a clumsy person, drop my phone all the time. My screen's still good because it's Samsung. So I trust this. It's how I feel about the brand. We tend to create feelings towards every brand that we see or interact with, even if we do this subconsciously. So brand posts are really who are you and why should I care? I create things that give your customer a chance to create an opinion about you. So branding posts, introductions to your team, why you started the business, what your values of your business are, essentially your identity. After that, capability posts. Capability posts get confused with sales posts, but they're not selling. Capability is all about what you can do for your customers. This works nicely if you've got a product or you've got a service. If it's product-based, you can do this is my product of the week. I really like this product for these reasons. This product's great for these reasons. If you're a service-based business, then you can showcase, did you know that we offer this? Did you know that our team can do this? So you can create posts that really push forward what you can do for your customer. The next step after that is your action. Action ones are, we've just got our new website live. Go have a look at it. It's the this is our product of the week, purchase it. It's when you ask your customer to take action. As soon as your customer takes action, it stops being marketing, it becomes sales. Totally different. totally different techniques and skills required there. So action post, getting customer to do something. That can be as simple as, we are located at, our opening hours are these. These are the days we trade. We're now at this market. This is the region that we service. Call us today. Those sort of things. The final step is your testimony. Testimony is where you try and get the customers involved. You try and tell their stories. You've had a great experience at this webinar. You've learned a lot of information. Putting up posts with your customers who have had a great experience in your business, a testimony on what is good about it, then creates interest and draws other people in, which starts people going, who's this business? Which starts the journey again with branding. Okay, they know who you are. What do you do? Capability. Okay, what are, is there something here that I want? Take action. Testimony creates a loop that feeds back in on itself. Now, that's been my strategy for social media for a very, very long time, and making sure you get people in it. Social media is about people. You want to make sure that you have people in nearly every single post, every video, everything that you do on social media, because we're looking for things from our friends and family. Quickest way to separate something from being a generic ad is to have a person, someone that's real and is interesting and can engage with the customer. So put up your branding posts, put up your capability posts, put up your action posts, put up your testimony posts, and make sure that you have people in it. And every step of the way, try and tell a story. Storytelling is the reason why newspapers existed back in the day. It's the reason why people still watch the news now. They're looking for things that are going on in the community. They're showing interest in it. Storytelling is the reason why we form societies. So tell the story of your business through social. And with TikTok, you might reach the entire world. You might reach that small market that's in your area. And if you do, it could potentially be more work than you can handle. So this has been Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok. In this session, we've covered how TikTok works, how to create content, what you need to go viral, what's trending, and why you need to be on TikTok now. For those of you that are attending this workshop live, if you have a question, now's your time to ask it. If you don't have a question, let me know what was the best thing that you learned in today's webinar. You can use the chat functions below. For those of you that are watching this online, feel free to reach out to me at Business Station. My email is available on there. It's liam.f@businessstation.com.au. That's Business Station with three S's. All right, this one. Otherwise, this has been Liam from the Digital Solutions Program on behalf of Business Station for Don't Dance for Likes with TikTok.